estate, so Randy Marion Ford Lincoln, we'll check it out to make sure that car will start on these cold mornings and get you to where you need to be. Come see us today. Make sure you're tip-top ready to go. 2024 has started off cold. Let's make sure you are ready to go.
King of Price, RandyMarionStatesville.com.
Oh, shoot. Love you guys.
Good morning. Good morning.
LeBron James. LeBron James.
Good morning, LKN. I have no idea.
I'm not in on this.
I have a feeling of what this is because I know this song. Is it start of baseball today? Is that what just happened?
It is opening day.
Oh. I was like,
LeBron James.
I went to talk into the mic and there was nothing coming out. And I was like, Bill. And then Bill wasn't looking. And I was like, Bill. And then baseball took over.
Sorry. Yeah. I thought my cue said one there. It was an L.
Oh.
Yeah. Sorry, LeBron.
So Baltimore plays today?
Oh, yeah. We actually start off the season. Yeah, we kick it off.
Is that because of past season? Like, is it the same as NFL, like the winner?
No, we didn't win the World Series or anything.
Oh, okay.
We're just an exciting team, and we'll probably get the most views. Us versus the Angels today, 3:05 Eastern time.
Baltimore?
In Baltimore. Should be a scene.
It's going to be tough to get there.
Should be a scene.
It's going to be tough to get to the game.
It is going to be hard.
No, it won't.
Because the bridge.
For the fans.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good. Does people walk across the bridge? Scott Key?
It's a pretty long bridge. Yeah.
They definitely don't have a train, right?
They do not have a train.
Okay, all right.
Despite what
our president says?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, I missed that one.
Oh, yeah. You didn't see that one?
I missed a lot yesterday,
That was a good one. Good morning, LKN.
Go Orioles.
7:08. Happy fun day to you. We got a busy day here.
It is a busy day.
Welcome back, by the way, Mames. Opening day.
Thanks.
Opening day in baseball. So for all you baseball fans out there, you American or National League?
I'm an AL guy, but I like baseball, so I'll watch them all.
So all the leagues.
Yeah.
We'll take them all on. Bartaco's coming in today.
That's right.
New spot in Birkdale, though not a new spot in general, but they are new to Birkdale, and they're having an event coming up.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it's April 11th. Am I right about that?
Yeah, Thursday.
Not next, but the following Thursday.
2 weeks from today.
And it is a paid event. You got to buy tickets for it, and because it's basically kind of a celebratory party. You're not having to like order like individual meals.
Right.
What's included with coming, so you get delicious bites and cocktails, make your own margarita bar, tequila tasting, live music, photo booth. It's gonna be just a party.
It's a blowout. It's a bartaco blowout.
Bartaco blowout. So bartaco Zach, the general manager, is gonna be joining us in studio at 7:30. We're excited to talk to him. Pharos Parenting. So it is National Child Abuse Awareness Month starting in April. Today is tie a blue ribbon on a tree.
It's called tie a tree.
And okay. So if you see the blue ribbons hanging from the trees.
Correct.
That's what it is. It's for awareness. So we're going to talk with Pharos Parenting. They're based in Statesville at 8 o'clock today. And then we got Ben McKethan, General Manager, Graystone Lodge, 8:30.
Busy day. I could have probably skipped today, too.
On top of all the things... You're funny.
Y'all got so much going on. I don't think you need me. I'm just going to go home back to bed.
Multiple times yesterday...
We need you.
Well, that too. But Michelle Fidelia, Miss Black North Carolina, randomly throughout the rest of the show, I told everybody, I don't know where Mamie's at.
I was in South Charlotte. It's just so far. I had to pack a bag.
It's another country.
I'm telling you. We'll have Jeff on at 7:15, but oh man, I should have ridden with him.
If he would have dropped me off,
I would have ridden with him. I should have called him ahead of time.
I think they drop off at the Cat Center though in downtown. You know, like right in Center City.
Maybe I could have paid like
$5
and he would have dropped me off at work.
Throw him another fiver?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's possible.
Because it was almost $6 for one exit of the toll lane yesterday.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Because you know, the model is built on the more traffic,
correct,
the higher the price goes.
I added to it. But yeah, I sat in it for a very long time yesterday. So
you got to listen to the show then on the way.
I did. I got to listen to the show almost in its entirety.
How painful is it, like, from that perspective?
I'm telling you. Oh, to listen? No, not at all. The traffic, extremely. To listen was very enjoyable, but it was fun. But I appreciated you guys kicking it off with the food, the McDonald's.
7:06, baby, yeah, right at the top.
That's my favorite.
With it. Yeah. So are you buying Krispy Kreme from McDonald's then?
Gosh, probably not.
Is it because the glaze? Is it the lack of flavors, or is it the combo of Krispy Kreme?
What Bill said yesterday, it's probably just going to be frozen, zapped in a microwave. It's not going to be a real Krispy Kreme donut.
Bill said that, or I said that?
Somebody said that.
I think you said that. I agreed.
Somebody said that it was just going to be.
You get the credit, Justin.
I said, but Bill said that the other Bill said.
I wasn't watching. I was just listening. So maybe I got y'all.
All the voices just.
Yeah, they just all
the voices just.
All the guys' voices just.
Oh,
are you gonna do a Bill impression?
Yeah, I was about to.
Please do.
He started off pretty soft there.
Please do.
Hey. Come on.
Hey. Hey, I'm Bill.
Yeah, that's it.
That's not how I sound.
No, it's not how you sound. I don't know.
It might be. I'm not
good at impressions. I'm really not good at them.
You keep trying, though. Yeah. You keep swinging. Hey, it's
don't
baseball
stop.
Season.
Hey, batting 100.
1,000.
Oh, boy. 100. 100 not as good.
100's okay. Not good. Maybe not what you're batting.
Batting 1,000.
Batting 100.
Man, now that just makes a lot of sense. I have said batting 100 several times, I feel like, in the past couple of weeks, and people looked at me like, oh, gosh. I don't know.
They're like, oh,
it's
yeah.
Like one out of every 10.
I don't know if we want to do this with this guy or not.
They just think that tracks. Yeah, that's it.
Well, all right. I don't have any update on the bridge. My timeline did talk about a lot of conspiracy theories, but we're going to leave that to experts to investigate, and we'll let them figure things out. I did also see Amazon blimps and drones. I'm excited to share this with you guys today at some point. We'll talk about that little news action. I really, really miss Waffle House on 28.
Oh, man, me too.
And there's an opportunity here. There's an opportunity here. We'll talk about this throughout the day, too. I think there's an opportunity where we can get Waffle House back to exit 28.
I'm intrigued.
The closest one to me is 23. Is there one on 36?
There is
one on 36. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Mooresville, who's holding it down still. Shout out to Huntersville. H Vegas? Can we call it that because they have a Waffle House?
Okay.
M Vegas?
No.
A lot of Vegas's?
Let's start at H
Vegas. Let's see if it takes off at all. A question I'll pose to you today, Mames, at some point. When was the last time you went to a store to actually buy a computer? Mm. We'll talk about that probably at some point. Maybe. Maybe not. Yeah, it looks like you got a couple of things on here, too.
Yeah, yeah. Bojangles, new Bojangles, had a little sign fail.
Oh, no!
North Carolina. Yeah.
No!
Yeah. I wonder how much that costs. So, yeah, it'll be a good time. Good time to figure that one out. So, I found a solution to my gas pumping issue.
You did?
And it's not an electric car.
Wow.
I'm very intrigued about this. I am very excited about this, too. I found it at 4:30 a.m. and man, I could not wait to share it with you guys.
Middle of the night, firing off messages, looking
at
content.
4:30 a.m.
That's a fair question. I was up at 1.
I know.
Is that middle of the night?
Thank you for that notification at 1 a.m.
Okay, so you got the ping. I wasn't sure.
Yeah, I forgot to do the do not disturb last night. So,
do you leave volume on your phone? Like when it's on your nightstand? Like is volume on?
I think I had turned it on last night because I knew my dad was going to call. But usually it's on silent all the time, and I forgot to remute it after I finished talking to my
bing,
dad
bing,
last
bing,
night.
Bing, 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 bing,
yeah,
bing, bing.
So, yeah, lots of notifications.
Bill, you volume on the evenings, or you?
Typically, because I am very scared of getting my alarm not on.
Right. Yeah. You don't want the other setting to infiltrate the other setting.
Correct. Correct. Self-sabotage.
Right.
At that point.
Influence them.
Right.
Idiom, whatever. You know, I mean, there's multiple things that
you're
can happen.
You're saying words.
There. That's it. Also, a new student loan repayment program from the Department of Education. First, look at the streets when we get back.
We'll have more Good Morning LKN coming up on 105.9 100.7 WSIC.
I'm starting to dry things out today. We'll still keep some extra clouds around, but the rain will stay to our south and east, and we'll even have a few peaks of sunshine at times. High temperatures back in the mid-60s this afternoon. Heading into our Friday, the sunshine comes back in a big way, and it's a beautiful Easter weekend. We'll warm things up, too, approaching 80 by Saturday and Sunday. And that's your forecast from the WSIC Weather Center. I'm meteorologist Chase Myers.
Here is your WSIC community calendar. This Saturday, come enjoy Birkdale's first ever Easter egg hunt. Collect 10 eggs and then trade them in for special treats. The event is open to the public. No registration is required. There will be two hunts so all our little friends can have some fun. Egg hunt for ages 3 and under starts at 9 a.m. For ages 3 to 7, the hunt will start at 10 a.m. Saturday, Birkdale's first ever Easter egg hunt. Wagyu meatballs? French onion soup? Tomahawk ribeye? Epic Chop House is open again. Come out and have an amazing time in downtown Mooresville. For the best experience, a reservation is recommended. To schedule your reservation, visit epicchophouse.com. You can also call 704-230-1720. That's 704-230-1720. Welcome back, Epic Chop House, epicchophouse.com. Summer camps are just around the corner. Check out some of the camps happening at Kane Center for the Arts. Pottery for teens, paint, 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 Broadway through the ages, and many more. Kane Center for the Arts is offering week-long camps starting June 10th through August 9th. For more info and to register for any of the summer camps, visit canearts.org. That's canearts.org. Merlefest is back, April 25th through the 28th at Wilkes Community College. Featuring nearly 100 performers, including Old Crow Medicine Show, Sam Bush, Turnpike Troubadours, the Teskey Brothers, Nickel Creek, and more. Tickets and information at merlefest.org. Listen every morning to Good Morning LKN and follow WSIC News on Instagram for your chance to win tickets. Have an event you would like to tell people about? Yard sales, estate sales, and everything in between? Visit WSICnews.com and click on events to submit your event today.
That's Morning Pep Talk for Lake Norman, Statesville, with Justin, Bill, and Mamie, now on 105.9, 100.7 WSIC.
Good morning, North. No, good morning, North Carolina.
Carolina.
Good,
North Everyone's Carolina. Listening.
Good morning, okay.
The whole state.
7:18. Well, the baseball anthem that got kicked off at the start of the show threw me off. I bet you maybe opening day has got everybody wilding out on the streets. RideICats.com, alternative transportation. $3 each day, each way to commute from Irondale County down to the city of Charlotte. You do it in the HOV lane with Jeff. That's where you want to be when you're cruising Southside.
That's right.
Jeff, good morning to you.
Good morning, Justin and Maney. 77 southbound traffic is getting a little heavier this morning. There's no accidents to report now. 77 north, the same way. There's pockets of some heavy traffic. The secondary roads in Statesville, Mooresville, I've not heard of any problems. So hopefully it'll be a good Thursday for us.
Let's hope so. It's not raining. Is it supposed to rain today at all, Jeff? Do you know?
I don't know. The streets are drying up some, so which is a good thing.
We do like that,
yeah,
Jeff.
Yeah, Jeff, you got to tell them double me. So you're just traffic guy right now. If you want the weather, that's gonna that's gonna cost.
Yeah.
That's it.
Jeff, NCAA picks back up tonight. Who you got winning tonight?
Well, I'm hoping that Carolina wins. To be honest, I haven't really kept up, so I don't know who really is playing tonight, except for I know that Carolina's the 9:30 game. So
I'm going with Jeff on this one. I'm on Team Jeff tonight. Yeah. Thanks, Jeff. We appreciate you. We'll check in with you at 8:15.
All right. Have a good morning.
You too, sir. RideICats.com, alternative transportation, $3 each day, each way. Today's Thursday, so they're going to Winston-Salem today. ICATS can pick you up at your front door. Only $1 to commute from your front door to Winston-Salem and $1 to come back. Kind of a killer deal. It's hard to beat it.
Can't beat it.
Good morning, North Carolina. Kind of had a nice little ring to it, didn't it?
Yeah, we're starting a new show.
Well, everybody's heard about the bird. Bird.
It's time for the word of the day. What's the word?
Word of the day. Give us the Megillah, Billa.
Well done.
Thank you. That was yesterday's word of the day.
I know that.
Megillah.
That's good.
Today's Word of the Day, presented by Merlefest. Merlefest, April 25th through the 28th.
Megillah means full story, by the way.
Sorry, I got my chair on low.
Whoa, yeah, just a little raise here we go. Up action here we go. There.
Calling up to the big leagues.
Hey-o.
Today's Word of the Day, again, presented by Merlefest. We're dealing with an adjective here, a word that I've heard quite often, maybe never in its full length. Today's word is auxiliary.
Mm. Auxiliary. Not to be confused with auxiliary.
I don't know.
How do you spell it?
For those following along at home, we're dealing with an adjective here. A-U-X-I-L-I-A-R-Y.
Auxiliary.
Yes. Now, that's precisely right. However, Webster's dictionary has the pronunciation. Maybe we've been saying it a little off.
Auxiliary, like additional,
extra.
Extra.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys are flirting with it already. How about this sentence? The auditorium has an auxiliary cooling system used only on particularly sweltering days.
It's for like overflow.
Additional.
Yeah, extra for overflow purposes.
More. If you, when needed,
I can tell you guys want it real bad.
When you don't have enough,
you use this.
Use the auxiliary room.
Okay. Break here when necessary.
You guys are very close. All right, I'm going to go ahead and give it to you because I think we're kind of caught in a one-track mind. And you're not far off. You're not far off. In general use, auxiliary describes someone or something available to provide extra help, power, etc., when it's needed.
That's exactly what we said.
In linguistics, an auxiliary verb, also called a helping verb, is used with another verb to do things like show a verb's tense or form a question.
I think the pronunciation is also like as if it's a different
auxiliary.
Auxiliary?
Yes.
I'm just used to saying auxiliary.
Yeah. Right.
I thought it was auxiliary too.
Have I been saying it wrong my whole life? Is that it is the same word? I've just been saying it wrong.
Correct.
And like everybody I know has said it wrong too.
Like, right. Like plug that cable into auxiliary port 6.
Auxiliary.
Auxiliary.
Yes. Well, that's what I'm picking up.
The whole world is wrong then.
That's right.
Someone needs to correct that.
That's what I'm here
that's
for.
That's what
he's
doing
why
right
I
now.
Felt
today.
It was an interesting word.
Clip it. TM.
Trademark it.
Auxiliary. Auxiliary.
Auxiliary.
Auxiliary.
Auxiliary.
All right, auxiliary. Brought to you by Merlefest.
Auxcord.
Coming to you April 25th through the 28th at Wilkes Community College. We were joined by the festival director a couple days ago, Wes Whitson. He was telling us all about it. A lot of parking stuff already sold out. A lot of great opportunity, though, still for some tickets. A lot of cool RV parks around Wilkes Community College. Also going to be tied to a giveaway we're going to do with Graystone Lodge, where you're going to get a free two-night stay. And then a four-pack of tickets to Merlefest.
It'll be
a good time. So the two bands I keep coming back to, just whatever reason, you know, keep catching my eye. When I look at this lineup, because you know there's over 100 artists coming to Merlefest. Something just about Gravity Check Juggling and Jig Jam. Those two. Just every time.
You're going to be front row for both of those, right?
Every time I just scroll past them here on this lineup, just catches my eye. You know, who doesn't want to see Gravity Check Juggling?
I'll watch it.
I mean, gravity is the enemy of jugglers.
That's true. That is true.
It's like their main opponent, other than, I guess,
their own self.
Them, yeah.
Their coordination.
Oneself. Auxiliary.
And then Jig Jam?
Come on.
Just sounds like a good time.
That does sound like a good time.
Isn't that like a can jam?
I don't know if I should listen to it or eat it.
Sit on it.
Right. Hey now.
Well, maybe they'll hand out like jars of jam while you're there.
Oh,
that'd be good.
Different flavors.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
That'd be a good time.
Mentioned to you the Department of Education. Don't know how I landed on this last night. Well, I do know how I landed on it.
I can tell you how.
Okay, yeah, I do know how I landed on this.
You searched long enough.
So they put out a new, what they're calling the SAVE plan. You know, because there's this whole thing, right? Recently, fairly recently, I think, 30, 60 days, student loans became due again, like in the sense of you have to start paying it again. And so they've come up with a new income-driven repayment plan. An IDR plan is what they call it, giving you that inside lingo on the Department of EDU. The Saving on a Valuable Education Plan is what they've called this. Offers lower monthly loan payments. Fast facts that they give you here about it. It's an IDR plan. Again, an income-driven repayment plan. So it has to do with the amount of money you make, right?
Right.
And that's how they determine what your repayment is. The Save Plan lowers payments for almost all people compared to other IDR plans. Okay. Save Plan has an interest benefit. If you make your full monthly payment, but it's not enough to cover the accrued monthly interest, the government, aka the taxpayers, covers the rest of the interest that accrued that month. This means that the Save Plan prevents your balance from growing due to unpaid interest. So beginning in February 2024, that was 2 months ago, almost now. Well, a month ago, except come Monday, it will have been two months ago because Monday's April 1st. They will give borrowers who originally borrowed $12,000 or less forgiveness after as few as 10 years. Hmm. More elements of Save will go into effect summer 2024. So new income-based repayment plan here for student loan people. Figured it'd be good to give you guys that information, let you know.
Thank you.
That is very exciting and informative.
Thank you.
Do you have a website where people could go and learn more?
Studentaid.gov. That's G-O-V, in case you were wondering.
Yes.
For government.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It's a government-based...
for the people.
Organization. Well, not an organization. Entity?
Hmm.
Operation?
Right.
I think entity would
department?
Fit. Department, yes.
Arma? Auxiliary?
Auxiliary?
Entity?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is this the new thing? We're going to use the word as many times as possible.
We're trying
so we
to.
Don't forget.
I feel like we should.
Yeah.
That's to get
it's
the
a
whole
good
Megillah,
habit.
To get the whole Megillah.
That's right.
That's it.
Megillah was the right word?
Megillah is the right word. The whole story.
Got it.
You got it. You did a good job.
Thank you.
Super Start proud of you.
Dollars to remember
I feel
the
like
words
I'm working through
day.
It today.
Yeah.
I'm working through
You're
it
doing
today.
You're doing a good job.
You know, to get the whole Megillah, well, I guess I should write down, because I wrote down Megillah yesterday, and that helped me, I think, with saying it. Now, for today, the something auxiliary that you may want to know. You know, Amazon is planning to deliver by drones at some point.
I thought they already were.
I thought they were, too. I think they are, but I have not personally received, to my knowledge, an Amazon delivery via drone.
I mean, mine shows up like 8 o'clock in the morning. So, but
you hadn't had a 6 a.m. delivery yet?
Well, yeah. Okay. Well, maybe 6 a.m. Yeah, there's many mornings I'm leaving to come here and I'm tripping over Amazon packages coming out the door. So,
Bill, do they deliver via drone in the city of Charlotte?
No, they used to have the little robots.
What robots?
Yeah, they would just
Who got robots?
They would just like be rolling down the sidewalk, I promise. And they have like a little heart on there.
People start kicking them.
Nobody really. I mean,
get out of my way.
They certainly were tempting to mess with. Nobody really did. I didn't, at least. I was more fascinated that it knew, like, to stop at a crosswalk.
Did you, like, follow it around, like, with a camera and everything?
Right, where
like...
is this package? So I followed it around with my drone.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Intercepted the package.
Intercepted the package.
Yeah.
Well, now there's a picture, and I don't know if this is... I do not know if this is AI or not, but Amazon now has blimps and drones. And it appears what we'll see is the Amazon blimp, basically a warehouse in the sky,
yeah,
parked on top of a city, and little mini dronettes.
Okay, I'm watching this video, and this is scary. I don't like this at all.
It's a little real, right? It's
yeah, a little, it makes me a little bit scared.
Wait, there's a video?
Yeah, scroll to the next one.
Dang.
You didn't see the video?
No, I just saw the picture and I made it up in my mind. But now that I see the video that is accurate to the picture I had in my mind, I don't like it.
Is that what you were thinking?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like it at all.
I mean, I just see this thing, giant thing parked over, you know, Bank of America Stadium, drones.
Yeah, it looks like a attack or something.
Yeah, I'm getting Evil Empire vibes there.
Saying,
sure.
No, thank you. Can you
But
choose?
If you can get your package within 2 hours, does that change your mind?
No.
It's not worth it still?
I mean, what if I need something within 2 hours, I feel like I can go get it in my car.
Are these Tesla driven? Or what's the robot's name from Tesla? Artemis?
I'm not sure.
That Elon created.
Yeah, no, I know what you're talking about. I don't remember.
We can't remember. We'll call him.
I try not to name him.
Oh, wow. It gets too real at that point.
Right.
Bartaco up next.
Stay where you are. There's more Good Morning LKN with Justin, Bill, and Mamie on the way from 105.9 100.7 WSIC. Local starts here.
Well, starting to dry things out today. We'll still keep some extra clouds around, but the rain will stay to our south and east, and we'll even have a few peaks of sunshine at times. High temperatures back in the mid-60s this afternoon. Heading into our Friday, the sunshine comes back in a big way, and it's a beautiful Easter weekend. We'll warm things up, too, approaching 80. By Saturday and Sunday. And that's your forecast from the WSIC Weather Center. I'm meteorologist Chase Myers.
Hey, everyone. It's Matt Madison with Doug Madison Realty. You know, everyone I talk to is concerned about a housing crash. Well, here's the metric that you need to look at that's different from 2008. 2008, housing supply was at 10.3 months. Now, today, it's a little over 3 months. So as you can see, we still have a shortage of homes on the market, which means that prices will continue to appreciate in the foreseeable future. If you've got questions, give us a call at Doug Madison Realty, 704-873-7700.
When you have problems with your heating system, you need SHA Mechanical. Serving the region since 1975, SHA will make sure your system always stays in the best condition. Visit SHA Mechanical online at shamechanical.com.
This is Fred Lowry at Lowry Drug. We now have our own brand of full-spectrum hemp extract, also known as CBD oil. I personally manage this product as it was grown on my farm here in Iredell County. Was then processed and bottled here in Statesville. This is a true herbal extract with all the medicinal components intact. A product you can trust to be authentic. And since there is no wholesaler, it's at a price you can afford. Try it at Lowry Drug on Harkness Road in Statesville.
WSS City is looking for the best teacher in all of Lake Norman.
Oh, it's definitely our teacher.
Then go to WSIC's Instagram page and cast your vote. A winner will be picked each month on Good Morning LKN.
Brought to you by Nina's Boutique and Brighter Smiles of Davidson. Has anybody seen our teacher?
She's definitely accepting her award.
This is a Bloomberg Money Minute. Insurance payouts for Tuesday's bridge collapse in Baltimore could be among the largest ever in marine insurance. This is according to Lloyd's of London Chief Executive Officer John Neal. Investors today positioning themselves ahead of tomorrow's U.S. inflation report. It's a measure of inflation very closely watched by the Federal Reserve, and the report may show inflation picking up a bit. New York's Take-Two Interactive Software, one of the largest such companies in the world, joining with Swedish gaming and media company Embracer Group to acquire the Texas-based game developer Gearbox and their extensive portfolio of gaming intellectual property in exchange for $460 million in newly issued Take-Two stock. And Home Depot announcing its largest acquisition in company history, acquiring Texas-based SRS Distribution. This is a more than $18 billion deal, including debt. SRS supplies professional contractors, including roofers, landscapers, and pool contractors. Denise Pellegrini, Bloomberg Radio.
Give us a call now at 844-STUDIO-4. It's Good Morning LKN on 105.9 100.7 WSIC.
Good morning, LKN. 7:33. Happy Little Friday to
That's
you.
Right.
Little Friday already. Wow. Joined now by Zach Gauthier, GM of Bartaco. Good morning to
Good
you, Zach.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here. Bartaco, if you haven't seen yet, in Birkdale Village, beautiful, centrally located right there at the plaza, right across at the roundabout area. It's looking like it's been pretty busy there for you guys.
That would be an understatement. Yeah, it has been. The response from the community has been amazing. There's not a slow time.
What brings in the people more, food or the great service? Which one do you think capitalizes more?
I think it starts with our ambiance. Like people look in and they see it and they're like, that place looks incredible. And then they come in and then the whole package just kind of blows them away. The food, the service, everything. The fresh squeezed juices for the drinks.
And I had never been, the Bartaco in Birkdale is the first Bartaco I'd ever been to.
Right.
And it's not Mexican food. It's like Mediterranean vibe. So I'm Greek too. So okay. For me, this is like a good, It's like tacos, which are delicious Mediterranean style.
But then a friend of mine that moved here from California, she likes it because she says it feels more like authentic tacos that she would get out in California too.
Just authentic, good cuisine and fresh ingredients.
Flavors from all around the world.
So what's it like being the GM of a place where like literally you could eat 1,000 tacos a day?
It's hard to not eat pork belly all day, every day. It really is. It's so easy and quick. It's tough to not eat tacos all day long.
When in your life, let's look back, the first taco you've had, do you remember your first taco?
Oh God, when I was a kid, probably. I had probably ground beef with cheese and sour cream, and that is not what you're going to find at Bartaco, I promise.
Bartaco.com. You guys have an event coming up on April 11th, and the point of it is really just to celebrate with the community.
It's twofold, really. It's to kind of do like a grand opening thing for us to kind of, you know, like a welcome to Birkdale. But it's just as much about this charity that we're involved with, and it's a local organization here in Huntersville called Cool Kids Clubhouse. Amazing organization. They do work with pediatric cancer patients. They do a lot of great things, and like I said, they're local, so it's that was kind of a no-brainer for us to pair with them. So 100% of the ticket proceeds go right to that organization. So that's really the main driver of why we're doing this.
It's interesting because most restaurants, right, when they're having a grand opening, the focus is on them. Yeah. But the team at Bartaco has decided to make the focus again about the community and the wonderful things going on. Why?
We're a pretty big organization, but we're definitely community first, right? We do some of the bigger chains, you know, they pick those huge hospitals, things like that. We have a team made up of local managers that works with our team, our corporate team, to pick local charities so we can be more involved in the community. So like I said, the Cool Kids Clubhouse for us was kind of a no-brainer. They're right in Huntersville, and they do a lot of amazing things, so we want to be involved with local charities.
And again, the event, Bartaco, Cool Kids Clubhouse is who they're supporting. Thursday, April 11th, 7 p.m. You have to buy tickets.
You do.
And it's $60 a person, but you get, it's not just the ticket for the entry.
Right.
You've got delicious, the bites and the cocktails. Make your own margarita bar.
So it's $60 will get you all you can eat, all you can drink.
Fat and happy. It'll get you fat and happy.
Make your own margarita bar. We have a tequila tasting. We have live music. We're bringing a band in. It's going to be just a party. It's going to be a great time.
It sounds like it's going
to
be.
It sounds like a great time. Yeah. And also, like, knowing that you're giving back to a great cause in the community, too.
Yeah, we're giving back another way, too. We launch. So we used to do, it was called the Bartaco Secret Taco. And that would change every 6 to 8 weeks. And it was kind of a cool way for us to, like, drum up social media buzz.
Secret tacos.
Yeah. Not on the menu, so people would have to come in and kind of search it out.
Like Cheeto taco? You ever had a Cheeto taco
before? I've
not
had a Cheeto taco, but I'm going to suggest that to the culinary department.
Just throwing that one
out
there.
But the secret, when you say search it out, how do you find it?
So you'd have to kind of look for it on our Instagram page and find it. So we would get, you know, we started getting thousands of people coming into all the different Bartacos looking for these tacos. So we've kind of rebranded it to be more local, or I'm sorry, more community-driven. It's no longer the Secret Taco. It's now the Giving Taco.
Oh, so give me a taco.
So we're launching our new one on April 3rd. It's a soft shell crab taco. But the deal with the Giving Taco is every single taco that we sell, $1 of that will go to a charitable organization. In this case, for us, the Cool Kids Clubhouse.
Very cool.
That's awesome. So the tequila tasting, live music, photo booth too. So people can be there. Yeah. It's like going to be like a party.
That's a lot for. Yep. I mean, that you get a lot of stuff for $60. It's hard to go out for a night for $60.
Yeah, tickets are going fast.
Yeah, I'd imagine so. And I would imagine that the space is limited. So talk to us about kind of the process with Birkdale. We know Maureen, she's been in several times
Maureen's
here.
Great, yeah.
What's it been like with Birkdale and you guys liking the vibes there and everything else? Or
The people in Birkdale are phenomenal. Maureen, Pierre, they have been great. They actually come in 3 or 4 times a week just to check on us, just to say hi, ask if we need anything. North American Properties that runs all the valet, they've been super helpful.
Quality.
They're helping us with valet for the night of the party. So
nice.
Just the reception that we've gotten from everybody in Birkdale has been amazing.
When you're there, because you're there every day, I would imagine.
All the time,
probably like from here, you're going to go.
I'm going straight
guess.
There.
Yeah,
straight
I would imagine. Yep. Hey, nothing wrong with tacos at 8 a.m. I'm going to be honest with you on that one. When you look out across Birkdale, you drive through Birkdale, and you live locally, what's your take on kind of the Lake Norman scene right now, the culinary scene, and kind of how you see Bartaco kind of fitting in?
Yeah, I've been in this area since Birkdale was built. So I watched that whole kind of, I don't know if I'd call it a rebranding, but they basically just changed everything in there. And I think they've done an amazing job. All the things that they've brought in. One of the coolest things is that there's really no two things that are alike. There's nothing around like Bartaco, you know what I mean? There's every restaurant in there is completely different. So I think they've done a great job on who they've brought in. I personally think we probably snagged the best spot in Birkdale. I mean, the location's just unbelievable. It draws everyone's attention. And it's been, like I said, the reception's been unbelievable.
It was Corkscrew, I think, prior to?
Corkscrew, yeah.
It was, and a boutique.
Yes.
And they bought both of them and knocked the wall down. And
you know when, like, a business that people like, a spot people like, goes mm-hmm. away, they get a little upset. But I think they're going to be happy now with Bartaco. I don't think they're going to be mad.
You guys have done a beautiful job with the space, too. I've not been inside yet, but every time I walk by, it's just beautiful. The patio space is so gorgeous. So.
Yeah. It's a good spot.
Looking forward to Mames
likes
inside.
It. She likes it.
And I can tell.
Summertime, that patio is going to be a great spot to
yeah.
sit. And,
oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Already now, the past couple, there's been a few days already and you guys have been slammed.
Oh, yeah.
We came out, Demi and I, we went there for the St. Paddy's Day event. Of course, it's a luck in the village. Luck mm-hmm. of the village.
That Saturday, right?
And it was packed. Oh, my gosh. There were people waiting outside. There was lines everywhere. And I just wanted a margarita. I said, I can't even get a margarita mm-hmm. right now.
One of the cool things about Birkdale is that it's, you know, a social district.
Yeah.
So we have, you know, even if people don't come in to eat, they just come in, grab a margarita, and walk around Birkdale with it. So we've actually, we had a custom bar built that we're putting out in front. So
oh, wow.
you don't even have to come inside. You just walk by, grab a margarita, and
good vibes
keep going.
Right there.
Yeah.
Man, you're speaking my language.
I do want to. We're going to save the talk of the menu for the next segment, probably more so because I need to get a bib in case I start drooling. That's just to be safe. I think that's a better thing to do. We are going to post the link on our Instagram for people to go, for the tickets to buy, too. So we do want to help promote that. Supporting Cool Kids Clubhouse. It's very awesome of you guys to come in and support a nonprofit. But the kind of build-out process of, like, GM, did you have to be part of that, too, and, like, have your eyes on, like, kind of the stages and where things have been out through the process?
Yeah, I was able to get in there. I was traveling a lot in the beginning, going around to different bar tacos, but I was able to get in there at least once a week and just kind of watch the progress. And I got to walk around the GCs, and they asked me, hey, where do you want this? You know, what is this? How does this look to you? So I was able to do that, but they are very specific on how they design it. You know, we're big on ambiance and vibe and all that. So they're big on how they're going to put it together.
So what was your, prior to Bartaco, what were you in the service or food industry, restaurant tour?
I've been in restaurant management for over 20 years now. So
dang.
Yeah.
So you've seen some things.
I have. I've seen
a couple
things.
Especially in the Lake Norman area. You've been in the Lake Norman area this whole time?
Greater Charlotte area. Yeah.
But for the past 20 years.
In Birkdale.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sure you've seen so much change around here.
Oh, yeah.
And the way the restaurant industry has changed a lot, right?
Yeah.
The way people, you know, in a post-COVID world, delivery, online ordering, how big of an emphasis is that for you guys?
Oh, that's post-COVID, you know, the to-go food and the Uber Eats and the DoorDash and all that just exploded. I mean, it was, you know.
It's almost a necessity. Like,
it
if you don't
now,
do it.
If you don't do it, you're just losing sales if you don't do it, you know? I mean, it jumped up. To-go sales jumped up 30-40%. You know, right coming out of COVID. So, yeah, like you said, if you don't have it, you're throwing money away.
Now, do people have to go through DoorDash and Uber Eats, or can they order direct through Bartaco's website?
That's actually the best way to do it, is just go right through us, Bartaco's website, through our online ordering system.
And is it a smooth pickup process? You guys got all that worked out as far as all that?
I like to think so. Yeah.
So, bartaco.com, BARTACO, spelled like it sounds, if you hadn't been yet. You got to check it out. In Birkdale Village, they got an event coming up, again, supporting Cool Kids Clubhouse. Tickets are $60 a piece if you want to come. But that's not just to get in the door. You get the delicious bites and cocktails, make your own margarita bar, tequila tasting, live music, photo booth. You leave fat and happy.
Man, it's going to be a good time.
That's definitely going to be a good time. Celebrating Bartaco coming to the Lake Norman community, specifically in Birkdale. And a great time. You can just walk around with your margarita and have a good time.
And we do have a promo code for your exclusively for your
listeners.
All right,
guys. Yeah. Lucky you.
If you put in High Neighbor, you get 25% off that ticket price.
High Neighbor.
Yeah.
H-I?
Yep.
I think that's how you spell high, right?
That's it.
Okay. High Neighbor.
I tried to go with auxiliary, but the company did not go for it.
There it is. All right, we're hanging out with Zach Gauthier, general manager of Bartaco. Again, the event coming up April 11th. We'll post that link as well on the Instagram. Can you stick around for another segment?
I can.
We're going to analyze the menu.
Woo.
We're going to figure out what's the best. Coming back.
More Good Morning LKN with Justin, Bill, and Mamie is on the way from 105.9 100.7 WSIC.
While starting to dry things out today, we'll still keep some extra clouds around, but the rain will stay to our south and east, and we'll even have a few peaks of sunshine at times. High temperatures back in the mid-60s this afternoon, Heading into our Friday, the sunshine comes back in a big way, and it's a beautiful Easter weekend. We'll warm things up, too, approaching 80 by Saturday and Sunday. And that's your forecast from the WSIC Weather Center. I'm meteorologist Chase Myers.
Here is your WSIC community calendar. This Saturday, come enjoy Birkdale's first ever Easter egg hunt. Collect 10 eggs and then trade them in for special treats. The event is open to the public. No registration is required. There will be two hunts so all our little friends can have some fun. Egg hunt for ages 3 and under starts at 9 a.m. For ages 3 to 7, the hunt will start at 10 a.m. Saturday, Birkdale's first ever Easter egg hunt. Wagyu meatballs? French onion soup? Tomahawk ribeye? Epic Chop House is open again. Come out and have an amazing time in downtown Mooresville. For the best experience, a reservation is recommended. To schedule your reservation, visit epicchophouse.com. You can also call 704-230-1720. That's 704-230-1720. Welcome back, Epic Chop House, epicchophouse.com. Summer camps are just around the corner. Check out some of the camps happening at Kane Center for the Arts. Pottery for teens, paint, 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 Broadway through the ages, and many more. Kane Center for the Arts is offering week-long camps starting June 10th through August 9th. For more info and to register for any of the summer camps, visit canearts.org. That's C-A-I-N-arts.org. Merlefest is back, April 25th through the 28th at Wilkes Community College, featuring nearly 100 performers, including Old Crow Medicine Show, Sam Bush, Turnpike Troubadours, the Teskey Brothers, Nickel Creek, and more. Tickets and information at merlefest.org. Listen every morning to Good Morning LKN and follow WSIC News on Instagram for your chance to win tickets. Have an event you would like to tell people about? Yard sales, estate sales, and everything in between? Visit WSICnews.com and click on events to submit your event today.
Want to talk with Justin, Bill, or Mamie? Give them a call now at 844-STUDIO-4. It's Good Morning LKN on WSIC.
Good Morning LKN, 748. Man, I forgot the bib. I forgot to get
you
my
forgot
bib.
To get it?
We were chatting
talking about
during
food.
The break.
You know what? We're just doing what we do best and talk about food.
Zach Gauthier, general manager of Bartaco, grand opening celebration coming up Thursday, April 11th, in partnership with Cool Kids Clubhouse, local nonprofit. $60 a person gets you in the door, and it's not just to get in the door. You get delicious bites and cocktails, make your own margarita bar, tequila tasting, live music, photo booth. Man, leaving fat and happy. If you want to go, Hi Neighbor is the discount code too, right? If you want to.
25%
off. We're going to have the link on our Instagram, WSIC News. We'll share that too with LKN Memes as well. Hi Neighbor is that promo code, Thursday, April 11th. Okay, so now let's look at this menu, because I've held off long enough trying to determine what is the best taco. Zach, your favorite taco on the menu.
My favorite taco is the chorizo taco.
Chorizo.
Yes. All right. What else other than chorizo is in that taco?
Wait, so for those who don't know.
Chorizo is sausage, right?
Okay, all right.
It's a Mexican sausage.
That was for other people that didn't
Not
know
Not you. You
no,
knew. You
no.
knew exactly
for
what
other
that
people.
Was.
Yes.
So it's kind of ours is a Argentinian sausage, so it looks more like when we cook it, it looks more like a burger patty. Mm. So it's not like a crumbled Mexican style chorizo that most people are used to. So we do that with like a red chimichurri sauce and some diced onions on there. Our sauces, everything we do is fresh, and it's just packed with flavor. So,
do you cook as well? Are you like chef style too, or just the manager?
I have an executive chef and sous chefs.
So, do you make your own tacos when you make them at Bartaco?
I do, yeah, every once in a while, yeah. But our chefs are really good. So,
oh god, that's
sometimes
awesome.
I like to get creative and change some things up.
Well, it'd be dangerous for me to have full access to the ingredients at the shop here.
It is dangerous.
Start making different combos and stuff.
We have to, as managers, we have to taste test. You know everything that's in
there.
So,
I'm sure.
Yeah. It's tough.
Sheesh. All right. I had the Baja fish tacos whenever my wife went by there and picked some up.
Yeah, that's a winner.
They were, wow.
Second most popular taco on the menu.
All right, what's first most popular?
Pork belly.
Pork belly's number one.
Can't go to Bartaco and not have a pork belly taco. That's what we're known for. It's our signature.
I had my eye on that one for next.
Yeah.
I did try the chili lime shrimp, too. Is it chili or chile?
Chili lime shrimp.
Chili lime shrimp. Okay. I also got my eye on the roasted duck.
The duck is fantastic. That's my son's favorite.
Who comes up with these combos? You guys have like a secret lab somewhere, like Willy Wonka Choco Factory kind of thing?
We had just have an amazing culinary team.
I mean, because some of these combos, mushroom with queso fresco.
Not mad about that.
The seared chorizo, spiced chicken verde. I mean, again, this is why I needed the bib, because I'm here looking at the menu. Is it the rice bowls too? Is there like the gluten kind of stuff going on in any of this?
So
or
one of,
thinking of
one people? Of the coolest things about Bartaco is our entire menu is gluten-free.
The entire
Except
menu?
Except the kids' quesadilla, because that's on a flour tortilla,
right.
And then our desserts. Everything on the menu other than that is gluten-free.
Those bowls don't play either.
Those bowls are, that's one of my go-tos.
They are lethal.
Yeah.
A great lunchtime, filling enough, but not going to bog you down.
Great way to describe
it. Not going to lose your pep in your step.
That's
correct.
Right.
It's actually going to give you a little bit of energy.
Now, how about when after I polish off the bowl, I take one of these slices of tres leche.
Now that.
And I put that down.
That's a different story.
Yeah. Now that we're in a different game. Yeah.
I don't know what it is, Zach, but like, probably like 2 months ago, I tried some tres leche. And I don't recall earlier in my life really ever having tres leche, though I probably had it because I've had many slices of cake in my life. But tres leche is at the top of my list right now. How good is this tres leche? I've not had it. I'm full disclosure.
Yeah.
It is delicious. You won't have another one after you have ours.
He ain't lying. It's good.
Bill, you've had the tres leche?
I have.
Did you have a bowl and the tres leche and then take a nap?
No, I actually think because I used to live right next to a Bartaco.
The one in Atlanta?
Yes. It was my neighbor.
That could get dangerous. Yeah.
It was very dangerous. Yeah. I think we just got dessert one night.
That's enough.
Yeah.
And so, Zach, we were also talking about during the break, like, who's typically coming in and hanging out. You guys are seeing a lot of families come through Bartaco and hanging out there as part of the experience.
Yep, tons of families.
What's that like as far as people come in, they want to get a table. Is the space designed, high chairs, all that kind of stuff, or what's that like?
It is. The restaurant itself is pretty big and spread out. It gets a little tight when we're full and we're packed, but plenty of room to put strollers and high chairs and all that. We do. One of the reasons kids love us so much is we give every kid a coloring book when they come in, and that just kind of blows them away.
Oh, you'd have kids right there. You definitely have my
kids.
And
the parents like it too,
Yes, definitely.
Keeps them occupied, especially if they got to wait for a table. They can sit there and color for a little bit. So we're super kid-friendly, super pet-friendly. We have dogs on the
pet
patio
friendly.
All the time. Yeah.
You bring in Layla?
Bring in Layla, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She'll eat a taco or two, too.
There you go.
The other thing is, at some point, it switches to, I don't want to call it a bar scene, right? But kind of more nightlife-ish, right? You guys have that atmosphere and that vibe.
Bar is in our name. That's
that's true. That's a good point.
At the center of every Bartaco is the bar. That's kind of our focal point. Our bar fills up before anything else does. We have 30 seats at our bar, and that's the first 30 things that fill up when we open up.
And I'm on your website again, bartaco.com. I'm looking at the kitchen hours for the Birkdale Village location. It says 11 a.m. to late daily.
Late.
What is that?
We're there until the last person leaves.
Is that a challenge?
I'm just saying. I think I'm going to have to leave and head back with you after this.
If you guys, if you're hanging out at the bar drinking a margarita, we're not going to make you leave.
Man, did you do research on me before you came in?
I did. I knew exactly
what
I
like.
Yeah.
What's your favorite margarita that you guys have?
So people ask me that all the time, and we have a ton of amazing cocktails. Everything is fresh squeezed. If you come into the bar and you sit down and order a margarita, we are cutting the lime and juicing it right in front of you. It's as fresh of a drink as you can get. But the long answer to that is the spicy margarita, my favorite thing. It's, it's one of the simplest things on there, but it's my favorite drink on the menu.
Yeah, I do like a spicy margarita. How spicy is it?
I love spicy.
Okay.
I kind of have a high tolerance, but I don't think it's overpowering at all. It's just got, it's our Bartaco margarita, our regular margarita, but we just put a little bit of jalapeno extract in there.
I don't think it's, Demi just literally big fan of the spicy margarita, so I don't think it's that. She doesn't like spicy.
Yeah, Rob texts me too.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Everyone is loving Bartaco margaritas
right
now.
That's
what
I like to hear.
Is it bad that if I'm more of a mojito guy? Is that okay?
No, I love a mojito.
The mojito is great, and it's a perfect drink in the summertime.
And I'll tell you, it's hard to get a mojito here in Lake Norman. I've had like two really good ones, but most places don't like to muddle the mint, and so yes, anywhere.
Muddle the mint?
Yes.
Is that what it's called?
We
muddle it?
We do.
Yeah.
Let's muddle it up.
Yeah, I love a mojito.
There's one drink on this list that I think Rob would like as well. Ranch water?
The ranch water. Yes. Ranch water is really popular.
That's a thing. Yeah. Like, that's a Texas kind of thing, isn't it?
It is. Yeah, yeah, that's where it started. Yeah.
I don't know much about it. I just know I've heard it. I've seen it on
too.
The show.
Yeah. Yeah, you talk about food. I'll talk about the drink.
Okay. We'll separate that
had
out.
All of them.
Do you guys make custom cocktails? Like, if someone came and said, like, I want a blue motorcycle, let's say, well, you guys can do that?
If we've got the liquor for it, we'll make it. Yeah.
That's where it gets dangerous right there. Yeah. So you stick to the menu is what you want to do there. Sangria, also spicy wine? Is that what sangria is also known
as?
Not spicy, no.
How's the sangria there, though?
That's very popular. We do that one in a pitcher.
I would imagine. Yeah. That's what I was thinking. It kind of stays ready to go.
We do a clerical on top with fresh fruit on top of it.
Yeah, that's a good one for like a brunch, like a girl's brunch. Yeah, we usually do a pitcher of sangria with that.
How about the Bartaco team? Are you guys hiring full staff? You're ready to go? Are you always hunting for people and keeping a list? What do you guys like to do?
We're always hiring.
Yeah.
And we just, as the weather gets warmer, we're only going to get busier and busier. Yeah. So we're always hiring, constantly.
You seem like a pretty cool dude to work for.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. Thank you. What do you like? Like, what's your style of being the general manager there? Is it everyone, like, together? Are you more like, yes, chef! Yes, chef! Like, is it like that kind of stuff?
I am very hands-on. I like to lead by example. You know, I jump in with you. I don't scream. I don't yell at people. You know, I'm right there.
Can
you
tell Mamie that? She's kind of yelling at me.
She looks like she's ready to yell at you right now.
I'm a tough one to work for, that's for sure.
Zach Gauthier joining us, general manager of Bartaco. Bartaco's got an event coming up April 11th, and it is also in partnership with, and as of course I leave my page, here we go. Cool Kids Clubhouse, Thursday, April 11th, 7 p.m. Tickets are $60, so you do have to buy them in advance. We'll have the link on our Instagram. A 25% discount, thanks to Zach and the team at Bartaco, if you use the promo code HIGHNEIGHBOR. And high is H-I. Confirm that. That is
high
how
neighbor.
You spell that.
We'll spell it out for you on Instagram,
that's
on the socials,
right.
And we put it out there, too.
Delicious bites and cocktails, make-your-own margarita bar, tequila tasting, live music, photo booth. You leave fat and happy and have a great experience and a lot of fun doing it. Zach, what is it about Bartaco that makes it so unique compared to other places?
Sure. We do healthy, upscale-style street food in kind of a relaxed environment. Our main goal is that when you walk in, you feel like you've left the real world behind and you're on vacation. And that's kind of the feeling you get when you walk in. And people tell me that all the time. They say, God, it feels like I'm at the beach when I walk in here. And that's exactly what we're going for. And then we have delicious food and drinks while you're there.
So much of restauranting is the placement of the location of the restaurant. It just seems like such a natural fit with Birkdale and like this kind of social style now and events.
Absolutely.
It's different than what the complex used to be, as you know, because you've been here, from here for a long time.
Yeah.
Do you think that in the long term that kind of continues to grow and all of that around Birkdale, or how do you feel about that?
Yeah, it feels like it's only going to get better and better. You know, if you look across the street from Birkdale, there's development going on over there. There's just more and more coming to this area, which means more and more people. So as long as we execute and we do a good job, the people are going to be there. I feel like.
Well, then people got to eat.
That's right.
That's true.
All right.
Excellent vegetarian options as well.
Oh, yeah, good to know.
Yes.
Good call.
Yes.
Bill's lady is a vegetarian, so that's right.
Excellent.
Or pescatarian?
Yeah. Pescatarian. Yeah, she'll have some fish. Yeah.
Has she had the falafel?
She loves the falafel. Yes, it's that was our
great taco. Great. Yep. Yeah.
Absolutely. And I see you got a new cauliflower. I love the old one. Now I'm interested in this new pistachio cauliflower.
Very good. I like this one better.
Okay.
The new way that we do it. It's got a
I trust you.
It's got a hummus on there and then a pistachio chimichurri. Mm. It's got it's really, really
sounds
good.
Sounds fun.
Yeah.
Are we going to open for breakfast at some point?
We'll do breakfast tacos for you guys.
Breakfast to late.
Breakfast margaritas.
It's never too early for
never
a margarita.
Too early.
There you go. All right. Bartaco grand opening taking place April 11th in partnership with Cool Kids Clubhouse, local nonprofit. Visit the WSIC News and LKN Memes Instagram pages for the links. Zach, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you guys for having me. I appreciate it. Yeah.
Go by Birkdale and go to Bartaco. Great atmosphere, delicious food. I can't wait to try the tres leches, the duck, and the pork belly tacos. That's next.
Serving you better than ever before. WSIC Statesville, W290DK Mooresville, W264CU Statesville.
Concern about the cargo on the ship that brought down the bridge in Baltimore. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. That ship's still grounded near the wreckage of the bridge it collided with.
There's about 4,700 containers on there. 56 were holding hazardous materials. And in that NTSB press conference we learned last night, some have leaked.
Now, Fox's Griff Jenkins is near the bridge in Baltimore the morning after divers recovered two bodies in a submerged truck. Four other construction workers remain missing and presumed dead, but they won't search today.
Because they believe that the wreckage underneath the water is so hazardous towards the divers, they're going to move to the salvage effort to start trying to get cranes out here.
Iran-backed militants have again targeted an American warship in the Red Sea.
U.S. Central Command says it successfully destroyed four long-range attack drones in self-defense. The Houthis have waged a months-long campaign, first against commercial ships they said had links to Israel, then against the military alliance out there to stop them.
Fox's Jonathan Savage. Former President Trump's lawyers will go to court in Georgia this morning trying to get the state's election interference case dismissed, claiming it's criminalizing his free speech rights. Meanwhile, Ashley Merchant, a lawyer for a Trump co-defendant, tells Fox they'll also try to get the judge to remove DA Fani Willis over a romantic relationship with the special prosecutor she hired.
We're going to be arguing that his decision actually should have gone farther, and it should have actually disqualified her.
The judge allowed Willis to stay on the case because Nathan Wade resigned. The former president won't be in court there. He'll instead be in New York to attend the wake of a New York City police officer shot and killed at a traffic stop Monday. President Biden will attend a fundraiser in New York City with former presidents Obama and Clinton. And in a new Fox News poll,
26% of voters say the economy is good. 38% don't like how President Biden is handling it. Looking at the presidential race head-to-head, former President Trump has an edge over President Biden, 50-45%.
That's Fox's Gernal Scott. America's listening to Fox News.
Texting enrolls you into reoccurring automated text messages. Consent not required to purchase. Message and data rates may apply.
Hey, Dan, how you doing? Haven't seen you around the gym for a while.
Yeah, I've really fallen off. Since I turned 40, I just don't get the results I used to get.
Could be lower testosterone.
Lower T.
Yeah, I went through it a while back. Once you hit 40, your body has less free testosterone. I got Nugenix Total T, and it's made a huge difference for me.
I've seen that on TV. Is it for real?
Oh, yeah. The patented key ingredient is something called Testofen, which helps boost free and total testosterone levels to help you trim up and stay lean.
And it's made a difference for you?
Man, I feel like I'm in my 20s again. At work, in the gym, and in the bedroom.
Are they still giving out complimentary bottles for people to try it for themselves?
Yeah, you just need to send them a text.
Text ALL to 321-321 right now for your complimentary bottle of Nugenix Total T, the number one selling testosterone booster at GNC. Plus, text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenix Thermo, our most powerful.
Hey, Anna, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
All right, cool deal. We are on break right now. We'll be back in 2 minutes, okay?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can. Yeah, I can. Sorry, I don't know what you see on your screen. You might see Justin on your screen right now. I'm in the booth. Can you hear me? Anna, can you hear me? You still got me? Hey, Anna, can you hear me? Anna, can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Yes. Can you hear me?
Hold on. No.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
All right, let's check then. What's that? What's her yellow say? Settings on.
Can you hear me now?
Well, starting to dry things out today. We'll still keep some extra clouds around, but the rain will stay to our south and east, and we'll even have a few
minutes
of sunshine at times. High temperatures back in the mid-60s this afternoon. Heading into our Friday, the sunshine comes back in a big way, and it's a beautiful Easter weekend. We'll warm things up to approaching 80 by Saturday and Sunday. And that's your forecast from the WSIC Weather Center. I'm meteorologist Chase Myers.
This is Daniel.
And this is Marsha.
From NC Auto Repair. Keep that car running like new this new year by stopping by NC Auto Repair for all your automotive needs. We're now offering a customer loyalty program for your oil changes. If it's automotive,
Anna, can you hear us now?
We can handle it.
Yes.
Stop by and see us at
10:50. You're back in about 30 seconds.
Or call us at 980-223-2957. NC Auto Repair. And remember, if you want to go far, you got to service that car.
Now, back to more of Good Morning LKN with Justin, Bill, and Mamie on 105.9, 100.7 WSIC.
Good morning, LKN. 8:06. Happy little Friday to you. April is National Child Abuse Prevention Month. We're joined now by Anna with Pharos Parenting. Anna, you are actually getting to kick off this tie a tree, 8 o'clock. You're in harmony right now. Good morning to you.
Good morning. I am. We are tying a tree blue today. We're going to be in 5 different locations across Iredell and one in Alexander County today. Literally tying trees blue for child abuse prevention awareness.
Talk to us about Pharos Parenting, the history of the organization. You guys are located in Statesville. Tell us about the services that you guys offer.
Yeah, absolutely. So we are, first and foremost, a parent education center. So we do free parenting classes. We do an in-home program that's completely free. We can get some one-on-one support. We also offer court-ordered supervised visitation and a coaching program for parents with children in foster care.
And the event today is Tie a Tree Blue. And so you're hanging blue ribbons from trees throughout the community. You guys are in Harmony at 8 o'clock, Statesville at 10, Troutman at noon, Mooresville at 2, Taylorsville at 4 p.m., I believe, is what I'm seeing here at the schedule. Now, this isn't just Pharos. You guys are partnering. You guys are doing this in collaboration with multiple nonprofits today. Is that right?
Right. So I'm out here with Children's Hope Alliance, Dove House Children's Advocacy Center, the Department of Social Services, Guardian Ad Litem, and Iredell County Partnership for Young Children. So we have several staff members and volunteers out here tying a tree blue in the Harmony Park this morning. So we're going to be on the road all day.
So April being National Child Abuse Prevention Month, tell us about Pharos and where the mission of Pharos aligns with child abuse prevention. Where do you guys fit in that equation?
Right. So in 1979, the Exchange Club adopted child abuse prevention as their national project and formulated the Parent Aid Program. So it's an evidence-based in-home program. And we are one of 4 centers in the state of North Carolina that offers that. So essentially it's parent education for the prevention of child abuse. So if you teach them the skills, then it results in happier, healthier homes.
So trying to prevent child abuse from happening, intervening in people's lives before they get to a point that they actually commit the act of child abuse. Can you walk us through like a typical person who may be like someone who should consider looking into Pharos and the resources you guys offer?
Honestly, something that we've kind of started saying, especially this year, is Pharos is for everybody. So we do have people who have been referred through DSS or a doctor or a therapist, but we also have people that have been self-referred and just need some parenting skills. Maybe they didn't have that mother, that sister, that coach even, that was a positive role model in their life to give them some of the necessary skills to be a parent. But walking through it, it's almost like if you've ever seen the show like Super Nanny or Nanny 911, it's kind of similar to that. So we go in, we do an initial assessment, we make sure that basic needs are met, like food and diapers, things like that. We get them connected with resources, and then we build a plan based on that.
So the color blue represents child abuse prevention. Tell us about this day, tie a tree blue. Tell us about this and the symbolism, kind of the hope and the goal of it.
Absolutely. So I'm actually wearing a shirt now, so it says Every Child Matters, and it has all of the logos on the back. So it's actually, the color blue was adopted as the symbol of child abuse prevention and the pinwheel that represents a happy, carefree childhood by Prevent Child Abuse America. So we are just kind of taking that and getting on the streets locally and spreading that message. They have a day coming up that's Wear Blue Day. I believe it's April 5th. Don't quote me on that. But we are actually having an IRL in Alexander County Wear Blue Day that is going to be April 12th. So we encourage everybody to wear blue on April 12th, just in solidarity against child abuse.
Okay, Wear Blue. April 12th is the event, so wearing blue, showing your support. And you guys also have a physical location there in Statesville. Can people come by and see you guys if they have questions or want to learn more?
Absolutely. Please do call us. Call us 704-878-2227. You can give us a call. You can drop by. We'd be happy to show you what we do. Maybe see if either you'd like to partner with us by volunteering or sponsoring, but also if you are just interested in seeing what we do for services for yourself, we would love to have you.
And remind us again of the services that Pharos can offer, because it's quite a robust list that we were talking about yesterday.
So free parenting classes, we do a dad's class, we do a brand new parents class, pretty much anything that you could want in a class, completely free. We have a sponsor, Raymer Oil Company, that helps us with the cost of that. Parent aid, which is our in-home service. We have supervised visitation through the court system, and then a coaching program through the Department of Social Services that's for parents that have children in foster care. And we coach and attempt to shorten that time in foster care. But we also can teach workshops. So if you're a daycare provider, a church, anything like that, we'd be happy to come in and help out.
There's the concept of the pinwheel, and I'm reading this article on Iredell Free News right now, talking about the number of children who were killed at the hands of their parents or caregiver in 2022, 31 pinwheels being placed out in remembrance of those children. What's it like in a day-to-day to work in this organization that you're working in?
So it's a burden, but it's a joy of a burden to bear, knowing that you can make a difference. So we're on the prevention side, but several of the organizations here are in the intervention side. For example, Dove House, who helps children that have been sexually abused. So we see all stages of abuse. And I think that what we do at Pharos is particularly important because we don't know the impact. We don't know how many lives of people that we're going to touch that maybe would have had a history or have had a history of abuse, or maybe would have made a different choice later on. And because of the skills that they got from us, they didn't take that path.
The Tie a Tree Blue Day happening right now. Anna joining us from Harmony, where it's kicking off in partnership and collaboration with Children's Hope Alliance, Department of Social Services, Dove House, Guardian Ad Litem of North Carolina, Iredell County Partnership for Young Children, Anna with Pharos Parenting. How important is collaboration for your organization with other nonprofits and other community partners?
So important. So we don't want to recreate the wheel. So if somebody is doing something awesome, we don't want to start doing the same thing because it's just going to water it down. We want to support each other. We have constant contact with the different organizations that have a similar mission but are offering different programs. So, for example, Iredell County Partnership for Young Children has what's called the Pampered Pantry, and they offer free wipes and diapers, which are, as a parent of a toddler, very expensive. So a lot of times we will refer some of our clients to them to get stabilized with that.
All right, Anna with Pharos Parenting again today. Tie a Tree Blue. Pharos and the other partnership organizations going around started 8 a.m. this morning in Harmony. 10 a.m. will be in Statesville, corner of Trad Street and Water Street. Noon in Troutman at 125 Main Street. Mooresville, 148 North Main Street. Taylorsville at the County Courthouse. And it sounds like you've got a busy day ahead of you. Thank you so much for what you and the team at Pharos does. Pharosparenting.org is the website, Pharos, Pharosparenting.org, if you want to learn more. Anna, thank you again so much. Looking forward to find other ways to spread the word about the wonderful things you guys are doing in the community here in the future.
Thank you. Fantastic. Thank you for having me, and I hope that the community gets to come out and be a part of something special today.
Take care, Anna.
Thank you.
You should really stick around to hear what the crazy gang of three have to say next. Good morning, LKN, on WSIC.
Well, starting to dry things out today. We'll still keep some extra clouds around, but the rain will stay to our south and east, and we'll even have a few peaks of sunshine at times. High temperatures back in the mid-60s this afternoon. Heading into our Friday, the sunshine comes back in a big way, and it's a beautiful Easter weekend. We'll warm things up, too, approaching 80 by Saturday and Sunday. And that's your forecast from the WSIC Weather Center. I'm meteorologist Chase Myers.
Here is your WSIC community calendar. This Saturday, come enjoy Birkdale's first ever Easter egg hunt. Collect 10 eggs and then trade them in for special treats. The event is open to the public. No registration is required. There will be two hunts so all our little friends can have some fun. Egg hunt for ages 3 and under starts at 9 a.m. For ages 3 to 7, the hunt will start at 10 a.m. Saturday, Birkdale's first ever Easter egg hunt. Wagyu meatballs? French onion soup? Tomahawk ribeye? Epic Chop House is open again. Come out and have an amazing time in downtown Mooresville. For the best experience, a reservation is recommended. To schedule your reservation, visit epicchophouse.com. You can also call 704-230-1720. That's 704-230-1720. Welcome back, Epic Chop House, epicchophouse.com. Summer camps are just around the corner. Check out some of the camps happening at Kane Center for the Arts. Pottery for Teens, Paint, 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 Broadway Through the Ages, and many more. Kane Center for the Arts is offering week-long camps starting June 10th through August 9th. For more info and to register for any of the summer camps, visit canearts.org. That's C-A-I-N-arts.org. Merlefest is back, April 25th through the 28th at Wilkes Community College, featuring nearly 100 performers, including Old Crow Medicine Show, Sam Bush, Turnpike Troubadours, the Teskey Brothers, Nickel Creek, and more. Tickets and information at merlefest.org. Listen every morning to Good Morning LKN and follow WSIC News on Instagram for your chance to win tickets. Have an event you would like to tell people about? Yard sales, estate sales, and everything in between? Visit WSICnews.com and click on events to submit your event today.
They're back. More of Justin, Bill, and Mamie now. It's Good Morning LKN from WSIC. Local starts here.
Good morning, LKN. 8:18. Happy little Friday to you. Thanks again for Anna Pharos Parenting for coming on talking to us about Tie a Tree Blue Day happening right now. They're in Harmony, going to be making their way around the community. Pharosparenting.org, Pharos. Now let's get a look at the street and see what's going on out there. Ride iCats.com, alternative transportation, $3 each day, each way to commute from Iredell County down to the city of Charlotte. You do it in the HOV lane with Jeff. Jeff, how are things looking now?
Well, Justin, they're running slow just past exit 31, the Langtree exit in the southbound lane. There was a two-car bump-up right as you get to the lake, and it had had traffic backed up not only in the regular lanes but also in the toll lanes. So I'm running behind this morning, but they should be getting that cleared up, but you'll see a slowdown at Lake Norman there past Langtree. Also, traffic was slowed down from Cornelius, really almost to 485 this morning, southbound. And then when you get to about Trade Street in Charlotte, traffic was slowed down there to almost a stop. 77 northbound, from about 485 up through Cornelius. There was some stop-and-go traffic there. Statesville-Mooresville, I've not heard of any issues on the secondary roads, but if you're going north or south on 77, expect some slowdowns.
Jeff, you're a daily commuter down to Charlotte, actually probably more than most because you go up and down a couple of times. Could we use another auxiliary road or lane?
Oh, yes. I mean, traffic is most every day, especially through the Huntersville-Cornelius area, it slows down. And and then with all the accidents north and southbound there, we definitely could use some more roadway.
What about like a tunnel? Like, what if the board, like Elon came through and bored a tunnel underground? Would you be comfortable driving in an underground tunnel, Jeff?
Well, I've drove through tunnel going to Ontario, Canada from Detroit, so it doesn't bother me. But I don't think they're going to tunnel through Lake Norman.
One can dream, Jeff. One can dream. We appreciate you. Ride iCats.com. Thursday, the day you guys are going to Winston-Salem, $1 to get picked up at your front door. Driven to Winston, $1 back. Jeff, we appreciate you, sir. Drive safe. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
Well, tomorrow I am off for Good Friday, so I will talk to you on Monday. But Bill, Justin, and Mamie, I hope that y'all have a great Easter.
Happy Easter,
you
Jeff.
Too, Jeff.
As a man of faith, it's one of our most important holidays to celebrate your risen Savior. So, anyways, God bless you and your families, and have a great Easter.
Amen, Jeff. We appreciate you, sir.
Bye.
RideiKites.com. Get there safely. Do it with Jeff.
So much wisdom from Jeff.
Every Always.
Day.
Constant.
Every day.
As I'm sitting here looking, I was actually thinking about some wisdom. This loopy thing you got going on the back of your phone, how is that compared to the,
Love
what's it.
It
called, the Pop-Its?
Much better than the Pop Socket.
Pop Socket? Pop, lock, and drop it.
Yeah, no, I prefer the loopy.
Does it hinder you? Does it limit you any differently than the Pop-It?
The only thing it hinders, no. The only thing it hinders is, like, when I'm in the car, I'm not sure where to put my phone because I have, like, a little holder that I would put it in. And I'd have to take the case off.
So it's the case that's got the loopy as compared to, you know, the Pop-Its can be independent of a case.
Yeah. But no, the loopy's the way to go. Not sponsored. They didn't pay me any money for this.
No.
It's
just
fantastic.
Testing the product.
I like it a lot.
I'm looking for an authentic review.
I prefer it over the Pop Socket. It has not changed my life, as people promise, but it's a pretty good phone case.
It's on the way.
And I've dropped my phone several times. It hasn't busted, so.
Do you think Waffle House changes people's lives?
Oh, man. I miss Waffle House so much.
Do you?
Yeah. On 28? Yeah, big time.
Is it just like the hangout in the atmosphere that was, or
no,
is it the
I
food?
No, I like the food.
Sure.
I mean,
it's kind of like home cooking.
I mean, it's good.
It's a flat top.
It's cheaper than most places you're going to go around here.
Less expensive.
It's like fast food, but not really fast food because, you know, you're sitting down, you're getting...
How long does it take to make a pancake?
Yeah, or waffle.
Or a waffle. Yeah, I guess a waffle, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's got a timer on it. Like, you know, you go to a hotel and, you know, it's got that timer, you do the little flip machine.
But I love a Waffle House waffle. I'd go there right
now. Do they
now.
Use the Crisco to make it crispy on the outside?
Mm, for sure.
Definitely?
Definitely.
Is the Crisco go inside the batter?
Yeah.
You've taught me this, I think.
Yes.
I'm trying to remember.
Yes.
I didn't know if you just kind
of
glaze it with a brush.
In place of butter. Yes. Not all the butter, just in place of some of the butter. About half the butter, replace it with Crisco.
Half the butter, replace Crisco. That's the combo
so
for
it's
making
like,
waffles.
For like, well, I don't know for waffle. I don't use butter in my batter, my waffle batter. But I just buy the instant pancake batter.
Well, there's hope for Exit 28. We may be able to get Waffle House or at least a crew of Waffle House back in because there's a Waffle House in Atlanta. And I don't know if it's entire Atlanta or is it one specific location. Bill, I don't know if you have any insight on that with your ties to Atlanta.
I know they roll tight together.
Yeah.
Waffle House is the birthplace, or Atlanta.
Oh, is that where it started?
Waffle House started, yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Original?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the Waffle House workers are on strike in Atlanta and to demand an end to their mandatory meal deduction policy, deducting $3 from every pay shift, regardless of whether they eat. And they say it's unjust.
What?
That's not fair.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I'd be
But they
about
get
that too.
To eat. They can eat.
But if
and
you
so
don't eat,
they still,
they still
the
take
three.
Your money. Yeah, that's not fair.
I don't like the way that sounds.
Oh, you don't like people just taking things without you saying it's okay to take it?
Yeah.
Especially from your money?
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's profits over people right there.
Yeah. Well, it is an election year.
Mm.
Yeah. Are they're unionized? Or is unions by state, not by organization? Like, I can't say Waffle House unionizes.
I don't
it doesn't
know how
work
unions
like that?
Work. I don't know how they work. Is it by state, you said? Or it's
I think it's by state.
Or by
like, North Carolina is not a union state. But there's organizations here that are part of unions, like auto workers.
Is there a teachers union?
Not in North Carolina.
Not in North Carolina?
No.
I thought there was. Sorry.
Shh, don't do that.
No, I thought there was. I'm sorry.
And I'm not hating on unions. I don't know
anything about them.
I think the origination of unions. But see, because like when I see on strike, that's what makes me think union. You know what I mean?
I think this is just one Waffle House in Atlanta that the whole staff just walked out.
Right.
I've seen this.
It's a single Waffle House that's leading the charge.
Not just like I saw a Dollar General where all the staff walked out and they just had to close the store for the day because of unfair practices. I think the issue at the Dollar General was that they were taking food. The manager wanted to take the food that was going to be thrown away and donate it to a homeless shelter or something like that. And the corporate people said, no, you have to just throw it out. And so they went on strike, walked out, had to close down the store for the day.
The whole day.
Yeah.
Just one, though? Everybody came back?
I don't know who came back.
Well, this one here. Let's play this video and see, because they do have a video for this waffle. Let's see if we agree with this or not. Let's see what their demands are. That's what I need to know their demands.
We just delivered our strike letter to our boss because we're demanding $25 an hour, 24/7 security, and the meal deductions to stop. We delivered a letter to tell them they had 2 weeks. Today is a 2-week mark, therefore we're striking for 4 days.
No changes are going to be made unless we do something and we hit their pockets. So that's exactly what we're doing.
We ready! What, say what? We ready for y'all.
All right. Now they're just yelling at me. All right. They're ready. $25 an hour, though.
That's a lot.
I didn't see that. I don't see that in this headline
that?
At
oh,
all.
You didn't see that.
That's not in the headline.
So you didn't listen to the video?
No, of course not. I just saw Waffle House on strike, bring it back to Corntown. We got a group of Waffle House workers ready to come back. That's what I thought.
Are you paying them $25 an hour? That's a lot.
To make waffles?
Yeah.
And I'm not hating on it. You know what I mean? I'm saying, though, like $25 an hour?
Yeah. Minimum wage is still at $7.25.
Let's do the math on that. Let's do math on $25 an hour.
How many waffles do you guys sell?
I'm going to assume a 40-hour work week, and I'm going to go 52 weeks. And obviously, we know that there's some room in it, but let me do it. So $25 an hour times 40-hour work week times 52 a year. So $52,000. That's a decent salary.
That's a decent salary. Mm-hmm. That's a decent salary.
For making waffles?
For making waffles. Probably. You know, you don't have to grow
it. And I'm not saying it's like the greatest work environment, because you got some unruly people that come into Waffle House, unfortunately.
I don't know that I agree with the $25. I do agree with the security definitely needed at a Waffle House, especially if they're going to be open 24 hours.
Some people can hold their own.
Mm. You think
some
so?
Some people don't need the security.
Well, some people do.
Waffle House security team in Atlanta, the Waffle House employees, you better come correct.
If you're going to strike the Waffle House?
Yeah, if you're gonna come to Waffle House, yeah, they're not.
You need to bring your own security.
Right. Right.
Oh, I thought the security was already provided. Like, you've seen the security guards there.
No, yeah, they're working. They're the guys.
The guys making the waffles.
They're making waffles and security.
Doubling up.
25.
Hence the $25 an hour.
Extremely reasonable.
Okay.
Yeah, you're doubling up the security. They should get paid 30. I'm not scared to pay people. Give them
how much
money.
You got to charge for a waffle, though, if you're making $25 an hour?
And that's my point. I ain't seen no Waffle House balance sheet right now to see or their profit and loss.
I'm sure Waffle House is doing just fine.
I'm sure they're doing fine. I don't think they're struggling.
Hey, cost has gone up, too, on the food.
Everything costs
more. You know
more.
What I mean?
Yeah.
Forks, plastic forks, metal
the
forks.
The $3, though, that's what I agree with. You shouldn't be doing that. Like
the $3 deduction, I think that's an easy low-hanging fruit. Hey,
yeah.
Stop taking it.
Stop
now, but
that.
Then this is what you're going to have, though. Well, all right, I'm going to eat something today. How do I take it out of my check just for today? Okay, make a note. Okay, I didn't eat today. I only ate half the plate. Can I do $1.50?
Why don't they just do, hey, you know, get 50% discount or you get one free meal or
sure,
something
just let
like
them pay
that.
Out of
yeah,
their,
just
yeah,
do
just
something
let them
like
pay
that.
Out of
that would make more
like
sense.
Like a coupon? Give
well,
a
Katie
coupon?
Worked at Hello Sailor, and so she would just, you know, pay half of what it would cost to eat. I think
that
she
was
got
the
a
deal.
Discount. I think it's 50% whenever she
I would imagine most restaurants offer their people deals on the food there. That just makes sense. Or even offering them a free lunch.
Yeah. I think I can't be for certain, but I feel like some of my friends who have worked at restaurants have said, like, if you're working an 8-hour shift, you might get a free meal. If you work like a half day, you can get a discount or something. But it just depends on how long you're working.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
And again, I don't think that this is all the Waffle Houses. Like, I don't think we're going to see a strike at the one on 23 today.
No. That place is packed all the time, too.
All the time.
They got no problems getting people in there.
It's just this one Waffle House in Atlanta has decided that it's enough. Enough is enough. Is it, maybe it's just Atlanta. Is Atlanta just enough? Do we need the security level like Atlanta's got?
Maybe.
Oh, well, somebody got shot at the one on 23. I forgot about that. Maybe we do need the security.
We need the security.
Dang. Great.
Stone Lodge.
Oh, no.
We'll have more Good Morning LKN coming up on 105.9 100.7 WSIC.
I'm starting to dry things out today. We'll still keep some extra clouds around, but the rain will stay to our south and east, and we'll even have a few peaks of sunshine at times. High temperatures back in the mid-60s this afternoon. Heading into our Friday, the sunshine comes back in a big way, and it's a beautiful Easter weekend. We'll warm things up to approaching 80 by Saturday and Sunday. And that's your forecast from the WSIC Weather Center. I'm meteorologist Chase Myers.
Cross over to the possibilities at Black Automotive. Cross over to the best of all, the Buick Envision, with up to $6,500 off. Black Automotive has rates up to 2.9% on select Buicks and GMCs. Black Automotive, Statesville.
The NASCAR Cup Series action is right here on WSIC. Don't miss this weekend's race, the Toyota Owners 400 from Richmond Raceway. Sunday, March 31st at 6 p.m. right here on WSIC.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle, unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze, and right now you can try it for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Does your business provide coffee for employees or customers? Black Powder Coffee can supply you with fresh roasted coffee. A variety of daily signature blends, including flavored coffees such as cinnamon roll and Kahlua and cream. We even have bourbon-infused coffee in collaboration with Southern Distilling Company. Visit blackpowdercoffee.com or stop by and see us at 261 Rolling Hill Road in Mooresville. Black Powder Coffee.
Grow in your faith with biblical teaching from the Word of God. Listen to Pastor Steve Pope from Calvary Baptist Church, Sunday mornings at 9 here on News Talk WSIC, or listen on demand at wsicnews.com.
This is a Bloomberg Money Minute. The CEO of Lloyd's of London says insurance payouts for Tuesday's collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore could be among the largest ever in marine insurance. CEO John Neal told Bloomberg News that the collapse will cost billions of dollars, but said it's a little too early to say exactly how much it will cost. Home Depot is making a big acquisition, buying SRS Distribution in a deal valued at about $18.25 billion. SRS specializes in distribution serving professional roofers, landscapers, and pool contractors. It's the final U.S. trading day of the weekend, the quarter ahead of the Good Friday holiday. Stocks turned things around yesterday with gains on Wall Street ranging from 0.5% for the NASDAQ to almost 1.25% for the Dow. The S&P 500 rose to an all-time high, and stocks are headed for a strong quarter. Gina Cervetti, Bloomberg Radio.
Give us a call now at 844-STUDIO-4. It's Good Morning LKN on 105.9 100.7 WSIC.
Good morning, LKN. 8:34. Happy little Friday to you. You might be looking to do something this weekend, and if you're looking to do something, you may want to go to Boone, North Carolina, to the High Country. And where would you want to stay? Definitely Graystone Lodge.
Absolutely.
G-R-A-Y, GraystoneLodge.com. Being joined by Ben McKethan right now. Ben, good morning to you, sir.
Good morning, folks. How's it going down your way?
Oh, it's getting sunnier. So it's supposed to be like 80 this weekend here for Easter. How about up there?
Yeah, it's gonna be nice. I think I'm looking at high 60s and 70s.
April 1st, right around the corner. Crazy to think about that. Monday is the start of a new month, start of a new quarter. For Grandfather Mountain, is that become a main attraction starting in April again, or kind of how does that work for Grandfather Mountain?
So Grandfather Mountain is a year-round outdoor activity for our guests to enjoy, but they really kick off a lot of unique programming starting in April. So, you know, we're going to be telling you more about that on our blog post as well on graystonelive.com. But, you know, every day there's activities, nature walks and hikes. Learn all about the ins and outs of Grandfather Mountain for sure. There's lots going on.
GraystoneLodge.com, G-R-A-Y, GraystoneLodge.com. Solar eclipse is coming up soon. Ben, I'm going to give you the same advice I've given everybody else. Don't stare into the sun. Don't do that without the necessary eye protectors. Any particular activities going on up there in the high country related to the solar eclipse? Do you guys have a better vantage point?
Speaking of Grandfather Mountain, they're doing actually on April 8th, the solar eclipse. They're doing a special event up there where basically, you know, the solar eclipse line kind of runs right through the middle of our country, if you've been seeing that online and whatnot. But they're saying 87% is going to be the it's going to be it'll be blocked by the sun, 87%. So it'll be actually a pretty good vision from up at Grandfather Mountain.
It looks like first 100 guests receive free solar eclipse glasses with emissions. I mean, that would be a spot to look at it at, mm-hmm. right? Like, you're clear from the top of the mountain? Not bad.
Yeah, and like a perfect designated viewing point. They've picked out the perfect spot on the mountain, and viewing time is between 2 and 3 p.m. on that day. So it's kind of a very unique day for sure.
The Mile High Swinging Bridge also there at Grandfather Mountain. As you know, Ben Daniels, not a fan of heights. And yeah. I was on the Mile High Bridge with him, wondering if maybe some solar glasses would help him make that journey across, because he would not be able to see everything around him. So that would be pretty good. Wilson Center for Nature Discovery. Can you talk to us about that at Grandfather Mountain and what those exhibits are like?
Yeah, so they've put a lot of money into the mountain the last several years. They've opened a brand new building called the Wilson Center, as you said. And in there, you're going to have 12 or so interactive exhibits as you walk through. They also have an auditorium area where they show videos. They have a really nice gift shop and restaurant up there in the visitor center.
Quite a bit to do. And that's where we drove it last when we came up to Boone for the basketball game against Auburn. The scene from Forrest Gump was filmed there going up the mountain. Have you sat on – isn't there a bench, I think, too, from one of the scenes there, Ben? Or am I making this up? Or I think there's a bench, too, that was part of the movie.
Yeah, so it's when he's running up the S-curves on Grandfather, and when you go through the curves, there'll be a sign that'll show you the exact curve where they did the filming. It's pretty cool.
That is awesome. Graystone, again, graystonelodge.com, G-R-A-Y. Graystone has a mascot. Is that right, Ben?
Yeah, so we've had a lot of fun creating our mascot. I don't know of a whole lot of hotels that actually have a mascot. It just shows you the level of interest that we have in being unique and kind of outside the box. So Snaggy the River Otter is our mascot, which we've introduced through social media and other outlets over the last several months. But it's just a lot of fun. It's interactive. Kids enjoy talking about Snaggy. We even have a little Snaggy River in the back of the hotel we've been working on, and our landscapers have made it really, really homey for Snaggy. But yeah, you can actually take a Snaggy doll home with you. We sell them in our lobby.
Snaggy.
I love this paint with an otter. That's so fun.
Sounds like a fun activity for the kids when they're staying. Because all of these things we're talking about, right, whether that be Grandfather Mountain or whether we talk about Tweetsy or we talk about some of the great, wonderful other local businesses there in Boone, it all has to do with, well, you still need a place to stay. And you want a great place to stay. And where your lodging should be done is Graystone Lodge. Again, G-R-A-Y, graystonelodge.com if you're traveling to the high country, because of the concierge-level service that Ben and his team provide. Ben, you guys also have deals for people, too, that are going to Grandfather Mountain. Do you guys have any deals with Tweetsy or anything like that as well?
Yeah, so glad you asked. We actually do sell tickets to Grandfather. They're discounted. You're going to save quite a bit of money just buying them directly from us when you get here. The other advantage is if you buy those tickets online, you have to kind of be assigned a certain time to go. With our guests, you literally can just show up, and so that makes it really convenient for you.
Totally. Tweetsie's opening up April 6th. Day Out with Thomas in June. July 4th, Canines, Ghost Train, Tweetsie Christmas. I mean, Tweetsie really does multiple events that I imagine people travel up to the high country for throughout the year.
Yeah, we definitely start seeing our Tweetsie crowd start rolling in the next week or so. Really excited about that. I drive by Tweetsie every day when I go home, and I've been enjoying seeing their interactive sign talking about upcoming events. Thomas is going to be coming in June, April 6th is when they're getting open.
Did you want to be a train conductor at one point, Ben?
You know, I was always more of a caboose guy. I like to ride in the back. I think that's fun.
It is cool because they still do like the cops and robbers kind of thing there on the train when you do the ride too through the mountain.
It's pretty fun. It's cowboys.
Cowboys, sorry.
More of a Western theme.
That's I should have known that. Yes, I should have. I mean, I've seen it, so I knew it.
I love Tweetsie too because it's something I did as a kid, and so something you can take your own kids to do too. Real nostalgic.
It's been there forever. I remember the theme song. Tweetsie, you're a blast from the past.
That is the theme song. I totally forgot that one. That's a good place to go.
Ben, do your guests sing that through the lobby after they've visited Tweetsie sometimes?
You know, I don't see that as much, but I do see a lot of kids walking around with their sheriff badges and their
cowboy
hats and cowboy hats and all the fun. So yeah, absolutely.
Somebody you've had on with us this on our ventures during the week, Ben, the Summit. And that's pickleball, I believe. Huge, huge phenomenon here. Obviously no different in the high country. Talk to us about the Summit tournaments that are coming up.
So the Summit is a great indoor pickleball facility that's just gotten open this past year. It has taken off. And they're scheduling tournaments, and a lot of locals are getting excited about it. You can do memberships. So April 13th, they're going to do pickleball with a purpose. And that's going to be a tournament. You can learn more about that on our, on our blogs, and we'll tag it through Instagram and all that. But those events are fun. They do food trucks. They pair that with beer, music, silent auction, those kind of things. And then April 27th through 28th is the Spring Slam tournament. That's a mixed, men's, women's, and then they do mixed on Sunday. So that's going to be a lot of fun as well. So another great local partner, something fun to do while you're here in the high country.
Something else that people will be thinking about here in the spring, which is crazy to think about already, but graduation, right? So App State, the campus graduation going to be taking place in May. What is that like when you near the end of the year throughout the high country? The end of the school year, I should say.
You know, I'm already seeing, as you drive through downtown Boone, just yesterday, I saw people taking their graduation pictures, the iconic locations throughout campus. So people start planning ahead for that. Yeah, so the families are calling ahead and getting their reservations booked. That weekend is going to be also the weekend that Adam Church is playing at the Appalachian Theater on that Friday night. That's going to be a huge weekend.
Wow.
Up in the high country.
Shout out to Adam Church, a friend of WSIC, and obviously a friend of Boone in the high country and Graystone and everywhere else. Wonderful, because he went to App State, and that's awesome. Friends with Luke Combs. So
that's right.
There you go.
That's right.
And then you've got the Appalachian Summer Series concerts coming to Kid Brewer Stadium. Ben, what's the sentiment and what's the talk around town about it?
We're just really excited about the lineup this year. They've announced a whole bunch of exciting people that are going to be coming up here. We always just get excited about outdoor concerts, indoor concerts. It's going to be a fun summer.
And we can't forget about Merlefest coming up at the end of April. We'll be doing a giveaway with Graystone. So four-pack of tickets to Merlefest, in addition to a stay at Graystone Lodge. We'll be announcing those details soon, so you're going to want to follow WSIC News, LKM Memes, Graystone on Instagram for your chance to win those. Ben, what do you want people to know about Graystone for the weekend?
For the weekend, this is a great pre-spring weekend. lot of fun things going on in the high country. Just a great time to get away, to get out of the hustle and bustle of Charlotte and the surrounding area, come up for a weekend. We still have rooms available. We're doing that deal still through the end of March where if you want to book two rooms, like to get an adjoining room, more room for your kids or family, one room is going to be full, regular price, and then you're going to get half off the second room. But you've got to call the hotel direct to get that, 828-264-4133. And then there's a link on our Instagram page where you can get 25% off if you stay more than three or more nights. So, you know, got some great deals out there ready to bring your folks up to the mountains and enjoy something a little different.
Ready to rock and roll, staying at Graystone Lodge, the best place to stay if you're traveling to the high country, concierge-level service, graystonelodge.com, G-R-A-Y, graystonelodge.com. Ben McKethan, general manager. We appreciate you, Ben. Looking forward to connecting with you again soon.
Okay, and have a great Easter weekend, folks.
You too. Happy Easter.
Three and under starts at 9 a.m. Grades 3 to 7, the hunt will start at 10 a.m. Saturday, Birkdale's first ever Easter egg hunt. Wagyu meatballs, French onion soup, tomahawk ribeye, Epic Chop House is open again. Come out and have an amazing time in downtown Mooresville. For the best experience, a reservation is recommended. To schedule your reservation, visit epicchophouse.com. You can also call 704-230-1720. That's 704-230-1720. Welcome back, Epic Chop House, epicchophouse.com. Summer camps are just around the corner. Check out some of the camps happening at Kane Center for the Arts. Pottery for teens, paint, 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 Broadway through the ages, and many more. Kane Center for the Arts is offering week-long camps starting June 10th through August 9th. For more info and to register for any of the summer camps, visit canearts.org. That's canearts.org. Merlefest is back. April 25th through the 28th at Wilkes Community College, featuring nearly 100 performers, including Old Crow Medicine Show, Sam Bush, Turnpike Troubadours, the Teske Brothers, Nickel Creek, and more. Tickets and information at merlefest.org. Listen every morning to Good Morning LKN and follow WSIC News on Instagram for your chance to win tickets. Have an event you would like to tell people about? Yard sales, estate sales, and everything in between? Visit WSICnews.com and click on events to submit your event today.
They're back. More of Justin, Bill, and Mamie now. It's Good Morning LKN from WSIC. Local starts here.
Good morning, LKN. 8:48. You know, tomorrow is the last work day of the month.
That's right.
It's actually Good Friday tomorrow, too.
It is Good Friday.
Teachers have off. I think the schools are closed for Good Friday, right?
Today is the last work day.
Today, I guess, technically, is the last work day.
And then spring break starts the week after for a lot of people.
Wow.
That's a big, big day. It's going to be a great Friday tomorrow.
So here's the thing. If you're a teacher, or you know a teacher, mm-hmm. or you submitted a teacher, or you submitted yourself because you are a teacher to the Teacher of the Month contest,
right.
you should be listening to the show tomorrow because we're going to pick our first winner.
That's right.
Teacher of the Month, thank you to our community partners, Nina's Boutique, mm-hmm. Located in Antiquity, $50 gift certificate.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you to Brighter Smiles of Davidson, a free gentle whitening treatment given away each month to a teacher that's selected. But you got to nominate the teacher.
To nominate the teacher, but tomorrow our first one will be selected. But if you don't win, don't worry.
Don't fret, don't frown.
That's right. You can win the next month.
Because you don't have to register every single month.
No.
We're keeping the running tally of all the great teachers in the around the local area. And so even if you're not selected, your name still stays in there for the next month. It's not a one-off. Mm-hmm. This is a continue appreciation.
Yep. But we're going to announce who's going to the winner tomorrow. You're on the air.
Maybe. No, I mean,
We will. We'll let you know who won tomorrow. So you got to be listening tomorrow to see if we picked your name, too.
Definitely.
And it's random draw. So everybody has equal chance to win.
Yep.
I'm excited.
As far as I know. I'm not on the list because I'm not a teacher.
No, I'm not on the list either. No. I'm not a teacher. Mm-hmm. I know a lot of teachers, though.
Know quite a few.
But yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited for our first winner. I'm excited for the contest. And thank you to Nina's and Brighter Smiles.
It's a great idea.
for being a part of this too.
I can't take any credit for it.
I wasn't giving you any.
No, I appreciate that because I can't take any. No, I appreciate that. So again, if you want, and if you want to register a teacher, WSIC News is Instagram, LK and Memes is Instagram, WSICnews.com. All those places lead you to the page where you register. Simple registration, name,
and it's
school.
Pinned to the top, so you don't have to scroll through to find it. It's just pinned right there on the top.
You really don't. And I think everything's spelled correctly. Can't say the same for Bojangles though.
I know, poor Bojangles. I hate it for him.
Is it Bojangles' fault? I could eat Bojangles right now.
Okay, who else's fault could it be if it's not Bojangles' fault?
The sign company?
Perhaps. So there's a new Bojangles that opened up in Knightdale, North Carolina. Do you know where that is?
Knightdale?
It's like towards the eastern side of the state.
It's near Chippendale?
I don't know. Raleigh-ish area, Research Triangle Park
definitely
area.
Definitely Chippendale territory.
Yeah, definitely. My old pal at the state you're in, he got the picture for me. So,
oh, nice.
Bojangles, spelled B-O-J. A-G-N-L-E-S. How would you pronounce that?
Bojangles.
Bojangles.
Bojangles. Let's all go over to Bojangles.
Not only, it's a new Bojangles that's opening up in Knightdale. Not only did they misspell the sign, but they installed it.
Yeah, they definitely went for it.
Yeah, all the way.
They shot their shot. Maybe nobody will notice.
How far do you get into that process before?
Oh, I'll tell you what happens. You get paid twice.
How's that?
It ain't the sign
they sent you a wrong sign.
Yeah, you proofed it and you agreed to it.
Right. Oh. The sign guys put it up. Now they're gonna have to take it down.
And doing it. Oh, so
and
the
we're
proof
gonna do
we
it again.
So we're, okay, so we're submitting a change order. That's what
correct.
We're
that's exactly.
That's what
we're
doing.
I just
want to
know how
now.
Many people had to look at this sign and say yes. Is it one, or is it multiple stages to get there?
You think like the general manager is standing out in front of the sign, looking at it as they're installing. Well. Looks like we changed our name. Did anybody get that memo?
Yeah. I just wish I could have been there and been like, the sign guys see it, good to go. The whoever made the sign gives a thumbs up. You know, at what point? It got to the point where this sign is on the building and somebody drove by and took a picture of it.
Right.
It's gone viral now. That's how they know their sign's spelled wrong.
And look, could we be upset if I were in and this is me putting on my Bojangle hat right now. If my Bojangle hat.
Mm-hmm.
Could I be upset at whoever was at fault in this process? Absolutely, I could.
I'd leave it.
Not bad marketing, but simultaneously, how about the fact that Bojangles is still open up new locations?
You have a problem with that?
No.
Oh.
I don't have a problem with Bojangles. I like Bojangles.
I like Bojangles.
I'm just saying, I think it's impressive that they're still opening up locations.
They're doing all right.
They've been around for a while in North Carolina.
They're not struggling at all.
Aren't they just North Carolina? Or is it beyond North Carolina?
No. They go beyond. They go beyond North Carolina.
But they're not nationwide.
They're not nationwide. They're
regional.
Like southeast.
Regional.
I don't know how far north or west they go. They're primarily in the southeast. So North Carolina, South Carolina, Tennessee, Georgia. I'm not sure how far west they go. But yeah, they're doing all right, I think.
They're doing all right.
They're doing okay.
Do you think they use non-antibiotic chicken?
No.
And they got that full antibiotic?
All the antibiotics.
Full.
I mean, they're not even proofreading signs.
That's I'm saying.
They injected the chicken in the back room. That's
Man,
what they're doing.
They're making some Bowberry biscuits right there, and they're just living their best life.
Throwing the antibiotics.
They're
on
having
that.
A great time over there.
It's like the new salt, isn't it?
The antibiotics, the new salt.
You want it
or you don't want
new,
it?
New pepper flavor.
You want antibiotics or no?
We got
none.
This new one we'll sprinkle on there for you.
I don't know.
We can put it inside. We can put it outside.
Well, I have found a solution to my gas pumping issue.
You did?
And it's not an electric car.
Well, so this has to be something so...
I got so hyped about this morning. And here I am, 4:30 in the morning. Everybody's asleep. The house is dark. And I'm just scrolling through my newsfeed. And I come across Juiced Fuel. Now, this is in Charleston, South Carolina.
Okay.
So I can't... Probably they won't come up here. Maybe. If I ask nicely, they will.
Mm.
This company will come to your house and fill up your car with gas. They have... regular, premium, diesel, ethanol, F, whatever that is, and they'll just come and fill it up. And the post that I saw was like, is your gas tank always on E? And I'm like, yes. Do you hate pumping gas? Yes. And they'll just come and they'll fill it up for me. So like, better than the Amazon that drops off at, you know, 2 in the morning. They're going to come to my house. They're going to fill up my car with gas. So when I get in to go, I don't have to stop.
All right, so first month subscription is free. It looks like appears based on the marketing here. $24 is what it is on the monthly subscription. or $8 for a single delivery. So in addition to whatever they're saying the cost of the gas is.
Correct. So it's a $24 per month, like, convenience fee for them to come. That's what they make every month. I'm paying it.
Do you get gas weekly, or how often do you get gas?
Well, I'm driving down to South Charlotte.
So more frequently now.
Yeah, usually twice a week now that I've gone up. I should have filled up on my way here.
So this is a killer deal for you, right?
Yeah, yeah. Saving money. I think I've actually got
the system rigged right now.
I think I'm going to be okay.
They're not going to be happy with you.
I think I'll just pay whatever it costs them to come up from Charleston twice a week and fill my car up. I might drive
right behind them with a little, like, truck full of Skittles.
Yes, I was going to say.
Snacks.
The snacks.
Start selling those in addition, too.
I'm saying cashiers don't have to worry. I got no problem with stopping and getting snacks. It's the pump and the gas part that I hate.
So you would still go, if you didn't have to go to a gas station, you would still go to gas stations? You go inside these places just for the stuff?
Yeah.
You intentionally say in your day, man, I need me a pack of Skittles.
Yeah, I do. I do.
What was the last thing?
I was there yesterday. What did you get
yesterday?
I got a Diet Sundrop Banter one. Because they were cheaper.
Man, you don't get more Carolina than that.
That's right.
It's a Carolina cocktail right there.
The high test tier one, right? Full on tier one, not diet. But then the Diet Sundrop because, you know, like healthy.
It. Did you stop at Cashin's too?
I stopped at Cashin's.
Stopped at Cashin's for a Diet Sundrop and a tier one.
I mean, that's where you know they're going to have it.
That's where they always have it. Yeah,
that's true.
They're always going to have it. It was on sale, 2 for $2.22.
The Diet Sundrop to cheer one is awesome.
I had a long day yesterday. I had to drive in that rush hour traffic.
But you didn't go to Bojangles?
No, didn't go to Bojangles. Didn't go to Bojangles. Mm-mm.
All right, well, this Juiced Fuel might be a thing. We'll see if the franchise comes up here. Juiced Fuel on Instagram if you want to check them out. They got about 14,000 followers.
Yeah, they're doing something. Yeah. The Charleston area. So yeah, if I ever go down to Charleston for the weekend, you know who I'm calling to fill my car up before I go home.
So you'll stop at a gas station to pick up a Sundrop and Cheerwine. Will you go to a store to buy a computer anymore?
I cannot remember the last time I purchased a computer.
How long have you had this machine?
This one is from my other job. They provided this for me. So I've had this one for about a year because I've been there about a year. Mm-hmm. Before that, every other computer I've had has been like provided by work
the company
and then if I like it when I leave I say, can I just buy this from you? And that's how I get a new computer.
Every time, just keep I'm already using it,
right?
Like, might as
and
well.
Like, what are you gonna, you're gonna have to clean it off, you're gonna have to do things, you just say, here, I'll give you some money,
take it,
let me keep it.
Yeah, you do not want to clear this as
you don't want to deal with what's going on here.
Well, because I saw this announcement, you know, I don't know the last time you've been to Best Buy. Shout out to Circuit City.
Circuit City. Remember Radio Shack.
So there's a post here from a, and I've not heard of this business before. Maybe I'm out of the loop. I don't know. I feel like I'm pretty up on current events and what's going on in the world. Micro Center. Have you heard of Micro Center?
No, never heard of
this. This rendering is one of the best I've ever seen in my life.
Micro Center calling all Charlotte customers. It doesn't look like a rendering. That's a real person walking through that, but that is not AI generated.
This is a rendering.
This is very AI. Yeah.
This is from a different location, shot on scene. This is what the headline says. Calling all Charlotte customers. The moment you've all been waiting for is nearly here. Our Charlotte location's grand opening will be May 10th. Does this business survive? Micro Center.
Mm. Okay, first thing I do when I see something like this is go straight to the comments.
Mm.
First comment. Can't wait to get some PC parts. They found their demo. There's people out there.
So this is for the super technical, is what you think.
I think so. It must be for people who enjoy taking things apart, putting them back together. That's not one of my strengths. The person also said that it was their birthday. A Micro Center pled back, happy birthday.
So it looks like the location is going to be 77 and Woodlawn area down in the south side of Charlotte. So, you know, kind of halfway between, let's call it the city and 485, right on the south side. And so it's going to actually be here. Meet Charlotte, meet Micro Center. It's excited to be here. And I don't know. It looks kind of like deep in the weeds technical stuff. So it might be like an outlet for people that need that kind of immediate.
Maybe there's a niche that needs that kind of stuff.
Yeah, like Amazon can't get it here and I need it before 2 days.
Right.
Right, that's the
before
segment
the blimp,
they're filling.
Drone, etc.
Right,
can get here.
No, go to Micro Center off Woodlawn. Don't wait. That's the way to do things.
Yeah,
I like it.
Happy little Friday. Hope y'all have a good one. Tomorrow being regular Friday. Regular Friday?
Good Friday.
Good Friday.
And a great Friday because we got so much fun stuff happening.
That's right. Opta Health LKN joining us tomorrow. We're excited to have them in. They'll be on at 7:30. We'll get a look at sports with Joe Burke. Speaking of Joe Burke, hosting Home Ad the rest of this week. Patrick Reynolds starting on Monday as the host of Home Ad. A buy, sell, trade, birthday anniversary, 844-788-3464. Love you, my Kip.
Serving you better than ever before. 105.9 100.7 WSIC, Statesville, Mooresville, North.